It's time for a little dance party to get us ready for a large group.
Ooh, I got the wiggles. How about you?
Man, I got them too.
I'm just a wormy squirmy. Ooh.
Why don't we get some people to help us out?
Arr, I like that idea.
Who's got those wiggle wiggles?
I got those wiggle wiggles.
Oh, who's got those wiggle wiggles?
I got those wiggle wiggles.
If you got the wiggle wiggles, come on, get your wiggles out.
Wiggles, get your wiggles out. Everybody shake and shout, let's wiggle. Get your wiggles out. Dancing all around now. Come on, wiggles, get your wiggles out. Everybody shake and shout, let's wiggle.
Tired,
me too.
I think we should all sit down together.
Ooh, yeah.
How about it? Let's do it.
One, two, three, sit down!
Ho, ho! You know what time it is?
It's time to hear a story full of wonder. There's so much fun we'll have learning together.
And this is our little red wagon. Isn't it great? Wagons are so much fun. Do you have a wagon? Wagons can be used for so many fun things. Like one time, I filled my wagon up with toys so I could bring them to my friend's house. But today, I'm filling my wagon up with something even better, even cooler, something even more wonderful. Today, I'm filling our wagon up with books! Lots and lots of books, like a library. I'm gonna walk up and down my street and share my books with my neighbors. I have books about space, I have books about farm animals, I have books about plants, I have books about colors. I think I have books for everyone.
Ho! Ho!
It's Ollie!
Hello, Zoe. Ho! Ho! That's a lot of books with you.
It is, Ollie. I'm filling this wagon up with books to share with all the people on my street.
Books are fun. Yes, it's true. I've got a story about a special book for you. Listen up. Just follow me through. Ho, ho.
Follow me through. Follow me through. Ollie's got a Bible story for me.
Good job, Stormy Jane. Oh, hi, friends. I'm Carrie the dog walker, and this is my best dog, Stormy Jane. Do you want to see the new trick I'm teaching, Stormy Jane? You do? Okay, Stormy, ready? Salsa dance. Here's your treat. Wasn't that great? And I learned it all in this dog trick book. Books help us learn so much. If I want to learn about dog training, I read dog training books. But here's a question. What if I want to learn about God? Is there a book I can read to hear from God? Yes, there is. And that's what today's story is all about. Are you ready? Stormy's ready. I'm ready. You're ready. So let's go. This true story from the Bible is about a king. Nope, that's not the king. The king was younger. Nope, that's not him either. Getting closer, but this king was still younger. There he is! This is King Josiah. He is 8 years old. Most 8-year-old kids are making artwork, or building with blocks, or playing at the park. But 8-year-old Josiah was king. King Josiah loved God, and he wanted to hear from God. Who else wants to hear from God? Me too. Well, one day, some of King Josiah's workers found something very special. They found scrolls with God's words on them. King Josiah was so excited. Show me your best excited face. Very good. Stormy Jane, great job. And great job, everyone. You look very excited. King Josiah was so excited that he began reading God's words so he could hear from God. King Josiah wanted to do what God said because he loved God, and he knew God loved him. God loves someone else, too. God loves you, and God loves me. That's why God gave us a book where we can hear from God, too. Do you know what book I'm talking about? The Bible, yes, you're right. The Bible is full of stories and words from God about who He is, how we should live, and how much God loves us. The Bible is like a big I love you from God. Oh, hey, Ollie. Ollie, tell me, who loves you?
God loves me. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who loves you?
God loves me. That's the truth, friends. See you next time. Bye.
So there's your story, and it's all true. The Bible is a book where you can hear from God. That's true for you, you, and you.
Thanks, Ollie.
Goodbye to you. Ho, ho.
Wow, King Josiah heard from God when he read God's words. I can hear from God when I read from the Bible too. I think I've got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good! You know what I think this book wagon needs? A Bible! That way people can hear from God in the most important book ever! I'll see you next time! Bye!
You know what time it is? It's time to go over our memory verse for the month.
God said, I will always love you. Jeremiah 31:3. God said, I will always love you. Jeremiah 31:3.
Get on your feet and let's get ready to worship.
I can talk to God any time of the day. He is always listening. I can tell Him anything when I pray. He is always listening. I can tell Him anything. When I'm done, I say, hey, 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 amen. Hey, 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 amen. I can talk to God, amen, amen. I can talk to God anytime of the day. Hey, hey, he is always listening. I can tell Him anything.
In our Bible story today, we heard how King Josiah found the scrolls of God's word, and he knew he was hearing from God. We can all hear from God. God wants us to hear from him because he loves us. So our Start the Conversation question is, how do you hear from God? How does he talk to you and tell you things that you need to know?